In this video, I'll cover stair landings, how to create them automatically, manually, how they interact with stairs, and how to shape them. Let's begin with the automatic stair landings. Stair landings can be created automatically with both the L and U-shaped stairs. With the L and U-shaped stair, they will open up a new shaped staircase dialog. In this dialog, there is the option to make winders with the landing, and in the case for U-shaped stairs, you can split the landing. For this L set of stairs, I'm going to accept the defaults. I'm going to come over, and as I move my cursor to one side or the other, you can control the direction of your stairs. I'll click with the up direction. You can see the landing is automatically placed. For the U-shaped set of stairs, again, I'll accept all of the defaults, come over here, and click a set of U-shaped stairs. Again, if you slide towards the wall, you can control the direction for the upside of the stairs. Let me undo this and let's place one with a set of winders and one with a set of split landings. And with the U-shaped set of stairs, let's click to make a set of winders. Come over here. You can see the winders are created, in this case, three of them. Undo. And one more time for the U-shaped set of stairs. Uncheck winders, create a split landing, and come over and click to place the U-shaped set of stairs with a split landing. The automatic landings that are placed with these two stairs can be modified. Let me press the space bar to get out of the placement mode. I'm going to come over, I'm going to modify these stairs slightly, click on the landing, I'm going to pull it up and snap it onto the stairs. Now this may change the overall travel of your stairs. These landings can be modified any way you want. Let's look at the process for semi-automatically creating landings. Slide our view up just a little bit. With the stair tool, I'm going to click and drag a set of stairs in this direction and click and drag a set of stairs in this direction. Notice my cursor is still in the stair placement mode. I'm going to click in between the two stairs and it will generate the landing. Let me press undo one time. You can also use the dedicated landing stair tool. Just click in between the stairs. It will then adjust the stairs to the landing and connect them automatically. Landings can be drawn manually. With the landing tool, I'm going to click and drag to create a landing. When you then drag a set of stairs up to it, they will connect automatically. I'm just going to click and drag to generate the stairs. Go ahead and pull the shape over so that it matches it exact. And then if you take a 3D overview, you can see that the stairs automatically connected with the landing since they snap to that. Landings can be shaped. You can also remove the railing off of one side. Let's look at the process of removing the railing off of one side. For the railing on the back, I'm going to click on the edge, and you can see the selected edge in this case has a red highlight on the back of it. In the lower edit menu is an option to remove and add the railing back. You can also shape the railing by using the convert line to arc. Let me add the railing back so you can see this, and that allows you to create shaped style landings. Landings have options for height controls. Let me double click to open up this landing. On the general panel inside of this dialog box is an option to automatically adjust the height. As you're connecting stairs to the landings, when this automatic adjust height is turned on, the landings will move with the stairs as they snap to one another. If you're doing a remodeling condition and you know exactly where a landing may be, you can turn off the auto adjust landing height. You can come in here and very precisely enter in the landing. That way it will remain in place. When you do this, the stairs will then snap to that landing and adjust automatically. If you happen to move the stairs back, let's go ahead and pull these back, and it may be a little bit easier to do this in a 2D view. Let's go back into the 2D view, pull the stairs, snap them to the edge. Notice that the railing panel disappears when you snap those stairs to the landing. The railing will automatically disappear on that landing and they will join, as you can see in the 3D view. Stairs can have multiple landings. If I draw a marquee around the existing stairs and delete them, and I want to come in here and create three stair segments and generate landings in between them. Using the Draw Stair tool, I'll come down, click and drag stair segment 1, come over, click and drag stair segment 2, and then click and drag stair segment 3. These are close. While I'm still in stair mode, I'm going to click in between each of the stairs beginning at the bottom. You may notice how the stair adjusts and connects to the landing automatically. Let's go ahead and click in between this one, and now the landings have been generated automatically. Press the space bar to get out of the stair mode. These landings are a polyline and can be shaped and adjusted accordingly. If I zoom in with the wheel on my mouse, I can take this one and create a straight segment. You can also curve the railing segment by using the Change Line to Arc tool to create custom stair landing shapes. To learn more about stair landings, please see the built-in help system as well as the other videos available on the website. Thanks for watching.